And this is back to his left. This is tibia and this is fibula.
Tibia.
Okay. But all the stones I think also. All the
stones.
Yeah.
Not
the hina. Hey, also. Why was your
progress
test?
والله.
No.
Progress test.
Yeah. Everything I don't know.
الان ما في شيء بس تعبان
شو
ما شاء الله ما بيعرف
لا 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 ما في شيء في شيء
الان لا شو بيتحرك بالكوخ
so this is tibia tibia is one of the medial one of the two bones in the leg and lateral one is fibula if you see the tibia tibia is a long bone it has upper end shaft and lower end
كبير
upper end shaft and lower end if you see the upper end of the tibia has condyles so to see to determine the size of the tibia you have to see the tuberosity in the upper end is anteriorly and in the lower end medial malleolus lying medially so this is right tibia why right tibia because in the upper end tuberosity is anteriorly and in the lower end medial malleolus is medially that is projecting downwards so this is right tibia has upper end shaft and lower end upper end has got the condyles we have medial condyle and lateral condyle and the median malleolus side is medial condyle and the other side is lateral condyle so we have two condyles medial condyle lateral condyle and we have tuberosity tuberosity of tibia or tibial tuberosity If you see the condyles, so from above there are smooth articular surfaces. These are called the plateau. This plateau of the condyles of the tibia articulates with the condyles of the femur to form the knee joint. So we have plateau. Between the plateau we have intercondylar areas. We have anterior intercondylar area and posterior intercondylar area.
For the intercondylar fossa of the
So we have anterior and medial intercondylar areas and you can see on the inner side of plateaus their upward projections. These upward projections are called the intercondylar tubercles. So we have medial intercondylar tubercle and lateral intercondylar tubercle. The prominent parts, prominent projecting parts are the intercondylar tubercles or the intercondylar eminence. So we have lateral and medial intercondylar eminence and intercondylar tubercles and we have anterior intercondylar area and posterior intercondylar area and we have plateau of the lateral condyle and plateau of the medial condyle and we have the tuberosity of tibia, we have a smooth part and rough part of the tibial tuberosity. Okay,
Where
so this
is
about the upper end of tibia, yes?
Eminence.
Don't go into it, okay, tubercle or eminence, this is. This, can you see these upward projections?
Yes.
These are lateral and medial intercondylar tubercles eminences. And intercondylar area is the rough part between the two condyles. Anterior one is the anterior intercondylar area and posterior one is the posterior intercondylar area. So if you see the non-articular part of the lateral condyle and the posterior aspect, can you see a circular facet, smooth one? That is called the fibular facet. This fibular facet articulates with the head of the fibula to form the superior tibiofibular joint. And at the posterior aspect of the medial condyle, can you see a horizontal concavity? This horizontal concavity is for the attachment of semimembranosus. So in the upper end of the tibia, we have lateral condyle and we have medial condyle. On the condyles we have plateau, plateau are the superior smooth articular area and between the plateau we have anterior intercondylar area and posterior intercondylar area and we have lateral and medial intercondylar tubercles or eminence and at the posterior end aspect of the lateral condyle there is a circular small facet that is called the fibular facet. It articulates with the head of the fibula to form the superior tibiofibular joint and on the posterior aspect of the medial condyle we have a horizontal concavity. This horizontal concavity is for the attachment of semimembranosus and on the anterior aspect of the upper end of the tibia below the condyles. We have tuberosity called the tibial tuberosity or tuberosity of tibia. We have a smooth part and rough part of tibial tuberosity. So this is about the upper end of tibia.
What is the name of this?
Horizontal concavity. Class?
Yes.
So upper end of tibia is very easy, nothing. Only two condyles again for you. For two condyles, medial condyle and lateral condyle. And in the condyles we have palatum, we have anterior intercondylar area, posterior intercondylar area, lateral and medial intercondylar tubercles and eminences, and we have fibular facet, and we have horizontal concavity, and the anterior aspect we have tuberosity of the tibia. This is about the upper end. Now the shaft of the tibia, like the shaft of all the other long bones, have
three borders
and three surfaces. This is anterior border. Anterior border is also called the shin, and we have medial border and lateral border is also called the interosseous border. Why? Because the interosseous membrane is attached. So in the shaft of the tibia we have three borders. This is anterior border, lateral border or interosseous border, and medial border. And three surfaces are lateral surface, medial surface, and posterior surface. If you see the upper part of posterior surface, there is a line that is starting from below the fibular facet, and it is going obliquely downwards and medially to end at the medial border in the junction of upper one-third and two-third of the shaft. This is called the soleal line. So in the upper one-third of the posterior surface we have soleal line. This soleal line starts from below the fibular facet at the back of the lateral condyle and is going obliquely downwards and medially to end at the medial border of the shaft at the junction of upper one third and lower two third. This is called the soleal line. Soleal line divides the posterior surface of the shaft of the tibia into the area above the soleal line and area below the soleal line. Area below the soleal line have vertical line. This vertical line divides the posterior surface below the soleal line into two areas. Area below the between the soleal line and the medial border, and area between the soleal between the vertical line and the lateral border. So again, this is the shaft of the tibia. In shaft of the tibia we have three borders and three surfaces. Borders are the anterior border and medial border and lateral border or interosseous border. Three surfaces are lateral surface, medial surface, and the posterior surface. Posterior surface is divided into two by a soleal line, an area above the soleal line, and area below the soleal line. The area below the soleal line is divided into two by a vertical line. An area between the vertical line and medial border, an area between the vertical line and interosseous border. The shaft of the tibia is very easy. Yes.
What is the importance of dividing the posterior surface?
Okay. Posterior surface, what is the importance? This is for the attachment of the muscles. The posterior surface above the soleal line is for popliteus, and the posterior surface below the soleal line is for tibialis posterior and phalanger hallucis longus. Tibialis posterior is towards the interosseous, between the vertical line and the interosseous border, and phalanger hallucis longus is between the vertical line and the medial border. So it is only for the attachment of muscles. So shaft of the tibia have three borders, three surfaces, very easy borders, anterior, medial, lateral, and surfaces are lateral, medial, and posterior. In the posterior surface, we have soleal and vertical line. Okay, this is lower end of tibia. In the lower end of tibia, there is nothing. Only medial malleolus and five surfaces, anterior, posterior, lateral, medial, and inferior. Yes?
This one, can we call it the styloid?
It cannot be called steroid process. Steroid process is in
skull.
In skull. And where?
Yes,
in the radius and ulna. And
so
in the skull. What is attached on the steroid process of the skull?
Attached?
Yes. Five ligaments and three muscles. Name the three ligaments. Three muscles attached on the steroid process of temporal bone of skull. Styloglossus. Very good. You know the nerve supply. What is attached on the just above the steroid process of radius? What is attached on the stoilet? Nothing is attached on the stoilet process. Okay. So this cannot be called stoilet process. It is medial malleolus. Medius. In wuzu, you have to wash above the medial malleolus. Medial and lateral malleolus both. Okay. So this case is it. The lower end of the tibia has got medial malleolus and five surfaces: anterior, posterior, lateral, medial, and inferior. Inferior surface articulates with the talus to form the ankle joint.
Hmm.
You're
going a bit fast.
Okay. No. Lower end of tibia has medial malleolus and five surfaces.
Yes.
Five surfaces are anterior surface, posterior surface, medial surface, lateral surface, and inferior surface. Inferior surface articulates with the talus to form ankle joint. Lateral surface has triangle rough area that articulates with the lower end of the fibula to form inferior tibiofibular joint. That is syndesmosis type of fibrous joint. There are only three types of fibrous joints: syndesmosis, gomphosis, and sutures. So this is syndesmosis, inferior tibiofibular joint. Medial surface is subcutaneous, and anterior and posterior surfaces are covered by muscles. This we will tell you.
The surface is exposed to the tennis, right?
Yes, medial, actually, medial surface of lower end of tibia is actually medial surface of medial malleolus. It is subcutaneous. It is under the skin. No muscle. You can feel medial malleolus.
Yes.
Okay.
Why did you say in the shaft? You said we only have three surfaces: anterior, lateral, posterior. What about the medial?
On the shaft of the tibia, I told you that there are three surfaces: lateral, medial, and posterior. In the shaft, there are three surfaces: lateral surface, medial surface, and posterior surface. Why there are three surfaces on the shaft? Because there are three borders. Three borders should make three surfaces.
The anterior border is subcutaneous, right?
Anterior border is subcutaneous. It is also called the shin. In marathon runners and in long distance joggers, there is a pain in the shin called the shin pain. This is actually in the anterior shin. It is subcutaneous, and it is the anterior border of the shaft of the tibia.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So these are the general features of tibia. So nothing. Upper end, shaft, lower end. Upper end, nothing. Only two condyles and tuberosity. Two condyles, nothing. Right. On the plateau, intercondylar area, intercondylar tubercles and eminences, and fibular facet and horizontal concavity. In the shaft, only three borders, three surfaces. Borders are anterior border, lateral border, and medial border. Surfaces are lateral surface, medial surface, and posterior surface. Posterior surface has solar line and vertical. Lower end has medial malleolus and five surfaces: anterior, posterior, lateral, medial, and inferior. Now muscles attachment. What muscles are attached?
We don't know the muscles either.
You know the muscles?
No.
Okay. You know, leg. Muscles of the leg. Muscles of the leg. In the leg, we have three compartments: anterior compartment, lateral compartment, and posterior compartment. Anterior compartment is also called the extensor compartment, lateral compartment is also called the peroneal compartment, and posterior compartment is also called the flexor compartment. There are four muscles in the anterior compartment. These are tibialis anterior, extensor digitorum longus, extensor hallucis longus, and peroneus tertius. There are two muscles in the lateral compartment: peroneus longus and peroneus brevis. All the muscles of the anterior compartment are supplied by the deep peroneal branch of the common peroneal nerve. And all the muscles of the lateral compartment are supplied by the superficial peroneal branch of the common peroneal nerve. In the posterior compartment, there are seven muscles attached, arranged in two groups: superficial group and deep group. Superficial group has three muscles: gastrocnemius, soleus, and plantaris. deep group have four muscles, and these four muscles are popliteus, and tibia is posterior, and flexor digitorum longus, and flexor hallucis longus. So it is so simple. All the seven muscles of the posterior compartment are supplied by the tibial nerve. Okay, class. Now it becomes very easy. Now they are in the anterior compartment. There are four muscles: tibia is anterior, extensor digitorum longus, extensor hallucis longus, and peroneus tertius. Out of these four muscles, one muscle, tibialis anterior, comes from tibia. Other three from fibula. Now you see, there are four muscles in the anterior compartment of the leg. In these four muscles, tibialis anterior is arising from tibia, and other three, which other three? Extensor digitorum longus, extensor hallucis longus, and peroneus tertius. These three muscles, they come from fibula. Class. Now very seriously, tibialis anterior is here on the upper half of lateral surface of shaft of tibia. So this is tibialis anterior. Class? Easy? No, very easy. Now before that, we come on the anterior lateral aspect of the lateral condyle. This is attachment of iliotibial tract. What is iliotibial tract? Iliotibial tract is the thickening of facial arta on the lateral aspect of the thigh. What is facial arta? Facial arta is the deep facial thigh, is called facial arta. Which muscles are inserted in the iliotibial tract?
Extensor.
Maximus.
Gluteus maximus and tensor facial arta. And iliotibial tract is inserted here on the anterior aspect of the lateral condyle of tibia. Now, you know, in the posterior compartment of thigh, there are four muscles. There are three muscles: bicep femoris and two semi muscles. Two semi muscles and bicep femoris. What do you mean by two semi muscles? Semi membranosus and semi tendinosus. So, semi membranosus is inserted here. This is. Semimembranosus is inserted on the horizontal concavity, on the posterior aspect of medial condyle of tibia. Semimembranosus. Okay? Now, we come on medial surface of shaft of tibia. In the upper part of medial surface of shaft of tibia, we have insertion of three muscles. This is
Sartorius,
and this is Gracilis, and this is Semitendinosus. So this is girdle between two soldiers. This is Sartorius, this is Gracilis, and this is Semitendinosus from anterior to posterior. Girdle between two soldiers. Sartorius on this side, semitendinosus on this side, and in the center, gracilis. So three muscles are inserted on the upper part of medial surface of shaft of tibia. Rest of the medial surface is subcutaneous. No muscle in the lower part. Only in the upper part there are insertion of three muscles. Sartorius is the muscle of anterior compartment, gracilis of the medial, semitendinosus of the posterior. Sartorius is supplied by the femoral nerve, gracilis by the obturator nerve, semitendinosus by the tibial part of ischiatic nerve. Very good. Sartorius, gracilis and semitendinosus, they are flexors of the thigh, and sartorius is also lateral rotator of thigh.
Yes.
And gracilis, adductor of thigh. And semitendinosus, extension of thigh. But all these three muscles, they are medial rotator and flexor of leg. These are medial rotator and flexor of leg of the nature. Okay, class. So on the medial surface, only three muscles. Class?
Class.
Now come on the posterior surface. On the posterior surface, on the soleal line, is far soleus. Soleal line and middle one third of medial border of shaft. This is soleus. Area above the soleal line is for popliteus. Area below the soleal line, on this side, on the introitious membrane side, is tibialis posterior, And here on the medial border side is pharynx, digitorum longus. This is, environment. And you know quadriceps, one minute. Quadriceps femoris?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Quadriceps femoris means rectus femoris and three vastae?
Yes.
Rectus femoris arises from the hip bone, three vastae from the femur?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Where is insertion of quadriceps femoris?
Patella.
But through the ligamentum patelli and the tuberosity of tibia.
I'm sorry?
Okay. Quadriceps femoris is inserted on the patella and through the ligamentum patelli on the tuberosity of tibia. What is ligamentum patelli? This we will tell you in knee joint. Okay?
Okay.
We will explain in knee joint. So these are the muscles on the tibia. This is iliotibial tract. This is semimembranosus. This is quadriceps femoris through ligamentum patelli. And this is sartorius gracilis and semitendinosus. And this is popliteus, and this is soleus, and this is tibialis posterior, and this is flexor hallucis longus. Flexor hallucis longus. Okay. Okay. Sorry. Cancel. Flexor digitorum longus. Sorry. Flexor digitorum longus. I'm very sorry. Flexor digitorum longus. Thank you.
And the iliotibial tract, where is it?
Thank you. Okay. The joints of the tibia. This is knee joint, and this is superior tibia fibular joint, inferior tibia fibular joint, and ankle joint. Tibia class. Now fibula. Any question in tibia? No. Very easy. Okay. Now, are you interested? There are six structures are attached on the intercondylar area of the tibia. These six structures on the intercondylar area of tibia, medial, lateral. These six structures from anterior to posterior are anterior horn of medial meniscus, anterior cruciate ligament, anterior horn of lateral meniscus, posterior horn of lateral meniscus, posterior horn of medial meniscus, and posterior cruciate ligament. Arrangement is like this. Number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. From anterior to posterior, structures attached on the intercondylar area are anterior horn of medial meniscus, then anterior cruciate ligament, then anterior horn of lateral meniscus, then posterior horn of lateral meniscus, then posterior horn of medial meniscus, and then posterior cruciate ligament. What are these cruciate ligaments? In this we will teach you in knee joint. In knee joint, the important ligaments, there are some intracapsular ligaments and some extracapsular ligaments. So cruciate ligament and menisci are the intracapsular ligaments. So menisci are like this C-shaped fibrocartilages. Each meniscus is attached by anterior horn and posterior horn. And a meniscus shape is like this. This is lateral meniscus. And this is medial meniscus. And anterior posterior cruciate ligament are these. Anterior, this very important function of cruciate ligaments, injuries, you know. This we will take in knee joint. So these structures, six attachments. Again, anterior horn of medial meniscus, anterior cruciate ligament, anterior horn of lateral meniscus, posterior horn of lateral meniscus, posterior horn of medial meniscus, and posterior cruciate ligament. So the cruciate ligament, cruciate, these are like this, attached on the tibia and on fibula. So this is about the tibia. Now fibula. Okay, it is right or left, where is upper end, where is lower end? So for this, to decide about the upper and lower end and about the right and left fibula, I have a golden sentence. If you remember that golden sentence, then you will become very easy. The golden sentence is that medial surface of lower end of fibula has got facet anterior, fossa posterior. Medial surface of lower end has got medullar facet and medullar fossa. Medullar facet anteriorly and medullar fossa posteriorly. Facet and fossa. Facet is anterior, fossa is posterior. Now, see this. Can you see at end facet and fossa very close? Yes. Here is triangular medullar facet and this is fossa. So it means that it is lower end, not upper end. Why? Because the low medial surface of lower end. Now, it is decided that this is medial surface of lower end, facet and fossa. This is medial surface of lower end. On the medial surface, facet is anterior, fossa is posterior. It means it is, yes, it is right fibula. Facet and fossa. Triangular articular facet anterior and fossa posterior. Facet is anterior, fossa is posterior. Where? On the medial surface. Which medial surface? Of the lower end.
Okay. Clear? This is applied to what to which bones? Only the fibula or?
Only fibula.
Okay. And we will go then what?
Only for fibula. Only and only for fibula. Not for any other thing. Only for fibula. Yes.
So we make it the lower end and medially.
Yes. In lower means there are two things, facet and fossa.
Yes.
Facet is anterior, fossa is posterior. Now if you put like this, now this lower end, yes. This is medial surface, this is facet. If you put on the left side, now the facet is posterior. Fossa becomes anterior, so it's not left. Okay, now look, okay now. Now facet is anterior, fossa posterior. But it becomes upper end. It should be lower end. Okay. Now facet anterior, fossa posterior. But it becomes lateral surface. It must be medial surface. So it is right. Okay. Now fibula, fossa, and facet. This is facet and fossa. These both are located on the medial surface of lower end.
Yes.
On the medial surface, this is anterior, this is posterior. To put it now, if not on the left side, left side, now this becomes MC. Now it has got upper end, shaft and lower end. Upper end, yes.
This is what's
wrong with it?
Right or left?
Right. Upper end, shaft and lower end. Upper end has got head and
neck.
Okay, head and neck. Nothing. Head and neck. In the head, there is an upward projection. This is called istoidal process.
Yes.
But not the tibia. And we have an articular facet. a circular articular facet. This articular facet articulates with the fibular facet on the posterior aspect of the upper end of the tibia to form the superior tibia fibular joint. Yes?
That's true.
One articular facet. So, fibula has got upper end shaft and lower end, upper end got head and neck. In the head there is a standard process of upper projection and there is a facet, tibial facet. This facet articulates with the fibular facet on the posterior aspect of the lateral compartment of the tibia to form superior tibio fibular joint. Clear? Mm-hmm. Neck is related to common peroneal nerve. Neck is related to common, sometimes if neck of the fibula is fractured, there is injury to the common peroneal nerve. And common peroneal nerve divides into deep peroneal nerve and superficial peroneal nerve.
Here is the sensation to the medial side, right? And drop.
Foot drop. Do you know about the foot drop, wrist drop and eye drop? You know all this. So this is... Do you know eye drop? Remember?
Yeah,
eye drop.
A wrist drop, you remember?
No.
Yes.
Due to?
No.
Really? Really no. Wrist drop occurs due to injury to
radial.
Another injury will result in wrist drop. And claw hand. Okay. So this is upper end. About the shaft. Now shaft of the fibula is difficult for you to digest. So please concentrate and try to digest about the borders and surfaces of the shaft of the fibula.
Again,
I'm not starting yet. There are three borders and three surfaces in the shaft. Borders are this is anterior border, okay, and this is medial border. Very close. This is anterior border and this is medial border.
Yes.
Can you see two borders? I make two lines. So lateral one is anterior border and medial one is medial border. Other name is interosseous border. Okay? Two borders very close, very close. Can you see me? Very close. Okay. And third border is, this is posterior border.
Where is the posterior one, doctor?
Here is posterior one.
That's two lines.
Can you see this? I make two lines very close, very close. So in this lateral one line, lateral one is anterior border, medial one is medial border or interosseous border. And posterior border is this. So these three borders divide the shaft of fibula in three surfaces. One surface is medial surface, that is between anterior border and medial border. So medial surface is extremely narrow. Medial surface is extremely narrow. All the muscles of anterior compartment of leg are attached or originate from the, this surface of the fibula except tibialis anterior. So this is medial surface and between anterior border and lateral, this is lateral surface. And between the interosseous or medial border and the posterior border, this is all this posterior surface. Posterior surface has got a line that is called the medial crest. This medial crest divides the posterior surface into grooved area. this grooved area is between the medial crest and interosseous border or medial border. And rest of the posterior surface is between the medial crest and posterior border. Shaft of fibula has three borders and three surfaces. Yes. Two borders are very close to each other.
Anterior.
Third border is this posterior border. Posterior border. Now, three surfaces are medial surface, extremely narrow, and lateral surface and posterior surface. On the posterior surface, there is a prominent border, that is medial crest. Medial crest. Okay?
Okay. And medial crest and the interosseous, the groove.
Okay. Medial surface is also called extensor surface. Why? Because the muscles of extensor compartment means muscles of the anterior compartment of the leg, they take origin from this surface. Lateral surface is also called the peroneal surface. Why? Because the muscles of the peroneal compartment of that, that is lateral compartment of that, take origin from this surface. Posterior surface is also called the flexor surface because the muscles of the flexor compartment, that is posterior compartment of the leg, take origin from here. Okay. So these are three surfaces: medial surface or extensor surface, lateral surface or peroneal surface, posterior surface or flexor surface. Okay. Now, these muscles. You know, in the posterior compartment of the thigh, we have three muscles: biceps, femoris, and two semi muscles. Two semi muscles are inserted on the tibia. We finish now. Biceps femoris is inserting on this istoidoid process of upper end of head of tibia. Okay, bicep femoris. Now we come on here. This extremely narrow surface is medial surface. Three muscles of the anterior compartment of the extensor compartment of the leg take origin from here. Extensor, digitorum longus.
Digitorum.
Yes. Extensor digitorum longus, extensor hallucis longus, and peroneus tertius. Extensor digitorum longus from the upper 3-4. Extensor hallucis longus from middle 2-4. Peroneus tertius from lower 1/3. Yes.
How many nerves? Longus.
In the leg, in the anterior compartment, there are four muscles. Tibial is anterior, and extensor digitorum longus, and extensor hallucis longus, and peroneus tertius. Tibial is anterior, take origin from the upper half of lateral surface, a shaft of tibia, and other three muscles are take origin from the medial surface of shaft of fibula. That is extensor digitorum longus, extensor hallucis longus, and peroneus tertius. Okay? Now come on lateral surface. There are two muscles in the lateral compartment of leg. These are peroneus longus and peroneus brevis. Both take origin from the lateral surface of shaft of fibula. Peroneus longus from upper 2/3 and peroneus brevis from lower 2/3. So lateral.
There is a third between them.
Third, middle. Why you are going too much detail? Middle third of the shaft of fibula have two muscles in the anterior half peroneus brevis, in the posterior half peroneus longus, like this. This is fibula. This is fibula lateral surface.
Okay.
Lateral surface, this is peroneus longus. And this is peroneus brevis. Now you have any problem?
No.
Don't go too much. Peroneus longus is from the whole of the upper 1/3 and posterior half of the middle one third, and pronotum brevis from the anterior half of the middle one third, and whole of the. So it's enough, you know. Palatalis longus brevis both from lateral surface, plus.
Okay.
Palatalis longus and brevis both from lateral surface. Plus. Now posterior surface. Now in the posterior surface must be for the muscles of posterior compartment of leg. Muscles of posterior compartment of leg are 7 in number, 3 superficial and 4 deep. Muscles are the superficial group of gastrocnemius, soleus and plantaris. These take origin from femur. Your plantaris was coming from lower one third of lateral supracondylar line of femur, remember?
Yes.
And gastrocnemius was from lateral head and medial head, if you remember.
No.
There. So this was femur. In femur, do you remember lower end of femur?
Yes. Tocondylus, epicondylus, supracondylar line, and the.
There was a muscular impression on the medial condyle.
Yes, for
of
magnus.
Femur.
Right. Adductor tuberosus.
Adductor magnus was on the adductor tubercle.
Yes.
Adductor.
Yes.
But on the muscular impression, there was medial head of gastrocnemius, and on the lateral aspect of lateral condyle, there was lateral head of gastrocnemius. Okay, so but we're not concerned about this.
Yeah.
We talk about this. Okay. So this is posterior surface of shaft of fibula. It is for soleus and muscles of posterior compartment. Okay. Now,
for attachment.
Okay. Can you see this groomed area between medial crest and introitus border? This is for tibialis posterior.
Mm.
Now you can make objection. You say, doctor, you said that tibialis posterior was from the tibia. Yes, it is from both tibia and fibula. And this is for flexor hallucis longus. And upper part for soleus.
This is a bit difficult because we didn't take the muscles.
You did not take, oh, no problem. Remember, posterior surface for the muscles of posterior compartment of leg. Class?
Mm-hmm.
Lateral surface for all the two muscles of lateral compartment of leg. Anterior medial surface or extensor surface for three out of the four muscles of anterior compartment of leg. Class?
Okay.
Now, we did not take lower and general features. If you see lower end of fibula,
that's
in
it.
The lower end of fibula, we have lateral malleolus and four surfaces, anterior, posterior, lateral, and medial. Anterior, lateral surface is subcutaneous. Posterior surface has a groove for tendina peronis brevis. Medial peronis brevis. Medial surface has anteriorly triangular malleolar facet and posteriorly malleolar fossa. This malleolar facet triangular in shape, it articulates with the talus to complete the ankle joint. And there is roughened triangular area above the medial, above this malleolar facet. This roughened triangular area in the lower end just above the malleolar facet, it is here is attached interosseous tibiofibular ligament, and it articulates with the lower end of tibia to form inferior tibiofibular joint. So this area is for inferior tibiofibular joint, and this facet is for ankle joint. The ankle joint is formed between tibia, fibula, and talus. Okay?
Okay.
Any questions? Any questions? I was fast. Now again I will repeat slowly, slowly. And 1 minute.
No, thank
you. Do you need I repeat slowly, slowly?
No. It's like this. No, thank you. Very good.
Very good. No. Fibula is nothing. It is upper end shaft and lower end. Upper end hood, head and neck. Khalas. Shaft, three borders, three surfaces.
Yes.
Three borders, three. Low and lateral manulus and four surfaces. In the upper end, bicep fibulas. In the shaft, medial surface for the muscles of anterior temporal. Lateral surface for the muscles. Posterior surface. And this is lower end.
Easy.
Attendance. After attendance, again you think to ask some questions and then you ask.
Mr. Tariq is going to come?
Yes. I think for the soft part, I think you have to go to the reception theater or stay here. Dr. Tariq will tell you.
Here are the. Why would all of this in one
person? You have an HIC exam.
Madrid.
Shall I? Which?
Shit.